We'll take some of this. Hopefully feel better and be able to run again soon.
Hey guys, so this is week 11, my recap for week 11. It's gonna be kind of short because unfortunately I did not run at all. You might be able to hear my voice a little bit, but I got sick this week and was unable to do anything. I didn't run, I didn't bike, nothing. So last Sunday I did my long run. My peak was 22 miles, did it at a 7:30 pace. Felt pretty good about it all in all. Monday was gonna be my off day and I started to have a sore throat, just was feeling kind of lethargic. And my kids had been sick earlier and I thought that maybe I had dodged this one, but it was just a little delayed getting to me. And so Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, I just was so tired and just felt terrible. So I took lots of naps. That was what I did this week. I've got my box of tissues here and got my water, staying hydrated. And I'm watching Boston Marathon course preview videos on YouTube. Because if you can't run, may as well just go ahead and get your head where it needs to be. And then on Thursday, I started to feel a little bit better and thought that maybe I was over the hump. And then Friday, I just felt horrible again. And I ended up going to the doctor. I felt like it had turned into a sinus infection, as that often is the case with me. And indeed, the doctor said it looked like I needed antibiotics. So
this is, I don't know, some kind of antibiotic. I think it's Augmentin. So I went to the doctor. I could tell it was a sinus infection. And he was like, yep, you got a sinus infection. So we'll take some of this. Hopefully feel better and be able to run again soon. The positives is that this is happening now and not in 2 weeks.
Today is Saturday, so I just started the prescription yesterday. I'm not really seeing any kind of a difference yet. I'm hopeful that tomorrow, Sunday, I'll see some improvement, and then next week be able to hopefully get back on some kind of plan. It was a little frustrating because I felt like this past week was really like the chance for me to get in a few more key workouts before taper time. And so not being able to do those was really discouraging. I am thankful that it is happening now and not like the week before Boston or a couple days before Boston or even in Boston. So I am thankful and looking on the bright side in that regard. However, it was kind of frustrating to feel like there's still work to be done and I was not able to do it. And I didn't want to run and overdo it and then just take even longer to recover because I had worked my body and pushed too hard. I also track my HRV pretty closely and have just watched it just go down lower and lower and lower and lower. That's really what the graph looked like. And so just knowing like it's not gonna do any good. My body's not gonna absorb any training and it's probably just gonna make things worse. So I exercised the discipline of forcing myself to rest this week. And like I said, I took lots of naps, drank lots of tea with honey, echinacea, zinc, all the things, and went to bed last night. I got like 10 hours of sleep. So if nothing else, my body will be very well rested going into this week. And so I'm excited that the antibiotics are gonna do their job and I'm gonna start feeling better in a day or two and be ready to get in a few more workouts next week, and then the week following really will be the taper week before Boston. So I'm hopeful that I'm gonna be feeling better and I'm gonna have some more exciting things to tell you next week and hopefully some more runs and things that I was able to do next week. So I look forward to checking back in with you guys next week. Don't forget to hit like, subscribe. I also just wanna say thank you. We've had a lot of new people to the channel within the last week or so. And I just wanna say thank you so much for joining us on our journey as we talk about running and triathlons and life and training and just all the things. We're really excited to have you guys along with us on this journey. And if you have dealt with sickness during a training block, I would love if you would drop a comment below and just share your experience. Like what works? How do you get past it? How do you get past the discouragement? Do you push through? Do you rest? It's just such a fine line, such a tricky thing. So would love to hear from you, and I will see you guys on the next video. Thanks for watching.
One day, I will have a training block where there's no injury and there's no sickness. And I will actually get in a full 16 weeks. This is not that training block.